And if this doesn't keep those pork chops frozen for a good 6 months, well then I promise that unlucky lady my next sweater set.
Oh!
I'm talking to you, Miss Allison.
I'm sorry?
I swear by the hairs on my chinny chin chin.
Oh, thank you, Rose. What a marvel, huh? I'm just glad it still burps when you lift the lid.
All right, lady. It is time for the final item of the night. Now, I know good and well you've all been aching to see it, and I've been dying to show it to you. Why, Allison has been an anxious Annie all week, calling, show me, have you tried it yet?
Stop.
And that goes double for the rest of you.
She's right. I borrowed so many cups of sugar trying to sneak a peek at the silly thing. I have enough to bake cookies for a year.
You should.
Well, the truth is, ladies, I have tried it, and it's an absolute dream.
Well, come on, Susie. Bring it out for Pete's sake.
No!
All right.
I heard it's indestructible.
Yes! That's why it doesn't have a warranty.
I heard it cleans every room in the house so fast you have an extra 2 hours at the end of the day.
No!
Mm-hmm.
Who said?
This is Lucille Ball. I read an ad right there in the Sunday paper.
I love that, Lucy. I never laugh as hard as when I watch her show.
She's a genius and a godsend.
A poet and a pillar.
You know, she's getting a D-I-V-O-R-C-E.
No.
I heard that kills children.
Well, I heard
Oh, be quiet, Allison. You didn't hear anything.
I'm sorry. Here it is! Ooh. All right, ladies, come down. Take your seats, please.
I have to talk about it, don't I?
Now, here we have the newest miracle in home appliances, at least to us. As you can see, it possesses full mobility. Push it around any hard surface and it rolls not only as smoothly as your modern-day bassinet, but it takes the burden off your back and shoulders, unlike your usual broom. But how does it work? Well, when flicking the on switch here, the engine inside spins the air into the bag here, thus creating a vacuum effect, which literally pulls the dirt right off the floor.
But where does the dirt go?
Well, into the bag, see?
Is it disposable?
You just toss that bag into the trash?
No, but you still can get rid of everything inside.
Well, that's just marvelous.
Isn't it divine?
Oh, I'm sorry.
How do you put back?
Oh, easy. It just snaps in just like that. It's that simple. And this plug here, when put into a nearby socket, activates it. And you can buy the whole thing down at Woolworths for just a little more than a pair of shoes.
Oh,
and that is, as they say, that. Any questions?
Yes. What about flight? Mm. Exactly how will this replace my broom? It looks a bit clunky.
Thank you, Rose. I'm so glad you asked. Ladies, we've all been living in the dark ages. Well, except for maybe you, Gail, and thank you for hosting us this evening. But the times are changing, girls, and we need a change with it. Now, I think we've all done pretty well since the good old days, considering a few personal sacrifices. Mm. We've done away with our wands, traded our cauldrons for modern cookware. Why, even our spellbooks now fit discreetly in our purses. The last of these cherished treasures is our brooms. Tom is always pestering me to get rid of that ratty thing in the corner, even threatening to do it himself. Good thing I can take the thought out of his head with a flick of a finger. But haven't we all had our fair share of close calls? Well, here is the answer to all our prayers. Not only is it modern and practical, but it keeps us hidden, maintaining that delicate veil we fought so desperately to achieve. No one suspects the woman in the vacuum.
But how does she fly?
Well, the same way our brooms do, silly.
Is it comfortable?
Very. Actually, the bag creates a great saddle effect, and the end provides considerable back support.
It looks heavy.
And how? Is that iron?
No, steel. It's true, metal craft can be quite difficult. I had my own misgivings about that, too, at first. But after applying the new varnish here and the toad scrub there, I assure you, she will fly as light as a feather by the next full moon. Oh, and this cord here, when wound about the wrist, acts as a fantastic steering mechanism, ensuring a smooth and serene flight, which is ward.
Can I say something?
Oh, of course you can, Gail.
how thankful I am to all of you for letting me know this little get-together. You've all been so kind to me ever since I arrived here, and I didn't know whether or not I could dare hope to find a new coven. But the moment I arrived, I sensed this place was the beginning of something good. And then Susie showed up at my doorstep with one of her green bean casseroles. Rose and Allison were next with their pies. Ingrid, I use your meat cleaver every evening for supper. And you, whose name I still don't know.
You can't, hon. It's my own doing. And also part of my charm.
You dish the best dirt on everyone in this neighborhood. I feel as if I've lived here my entire life. I've never felt so welcomed. It's enough to make a young single gal feel like she doesn't need a man to get by.
Hear, hear.
But honestly, I can't give up my broom. The broom is the very heart and soul of a witch. My mother gave me her broom, her mother before her. She built it with her very own hands. Why are we turning our backs on tradition? We witches who have woven the fabric of the world since the dawn of time, we know secrets that mortals have spent centuries inventing machines to discover. We shouldn't hide from these gifts. Our mothers did not burn the fire so their daughters could drop their brooms and trade their cats in for dogs. We must live as they did, without fear. Look at you. Each of you bears the face of your shame. Susie, forgive me, but that's not your natural hair color, is it?
Oh. No. Those eyes
aren't yours. Whose face is it? Whose body do you wear?
Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
She knows.
Who was she?
My stepdaughter.
Why did you kill her?
Well, frankly,
she was a bitch. No matter what the storybooks say.
You gave it all you got, didn't you?
You're damn right I did. I never used that much poison in an apple before. I never had.
What about you, Allison?
She was a mermaid. She wouldn't stop bugging me about this guy, so
I shut her up.
I didn't kill her or anything. Her voice was so annoying constantly with his singing.
What about Eric? You stole him from her.
He was hot.
And you, Rose. You put that girl to sleep for 100 years. Cover that castle with thorns to boot. Yep. You put that girl to sleep when she was just a week old.
She was ugly.
Oh. What? There are ugly babies. If you'd have seen her, you would have done the same thing.
And you, Ingrid. 2 children, a brother and sister.
They ate my house. So I ate them.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
And you.
I wanted a baby. Not to eat, but to love. I had given up on romance a long time ago. And then I met this princess. Mm-hmm. And she was so in love with her prince, but he wasn't convinced. And so she asked me to do everything in my power to get him. I said, sure, I'll do it. I'll do what I always do and get that prince for somebody else. But I want something. I want that child that you could care less about because you're so obsessed with this man. And she promised me. She promised that I could have the baby. But a mortal's promise is a witch's woe. Mm-hmm. And when I came to take him home, she refused me. And like a fool, I gave her another chance. I told her if she could guess my name, I'd call off the whole deal. I don't know how she did it, but she did it. And that was my undoing. All I wanted was to love something that could love me back. And babies know nothing else. After that, it took Rose and Susie here and Allison and Ingrid to give me this. You don't want to see how I really look.
But see, that's what I'm talking about. Who we already are, who we are meant to love. We shouldn't cover that up.
What about you? Aren't you in hiding?
Yes, I'll admit it.
ice skates get here, but I'm not ashamed of it. I've got a club foot, I'm bald as a cue ball, and I'm ridiculously fat.
Oh, wow, you look amazing.
I know, right? Who else?
I have four thumbs. Oh.
My beard is as long as my bush, and I fart like every 5 seconds.
See?
Good for you.
I have no teeth.
Mother was burned, not drowned.
Oh. No!